With the xViz Advanced Trellis Chart, you're able to show many small multiples within the same visual. In this video, we're going to cover some of the top features of the Advanced Trellis Chart. Firstly, you're able to switch between multiple trellis types. Right now, we're looking at the stack chart type. You can see that we have multiple stack column charts split out into small multiples. We can change this type by going to the formatting options, and under chart options, we'll have the ability to switch between stack charts, split panels, or animated charts. Let's look at split panels. So now we'll see each individual panel for that month and day name combination, or we can animate these charts. So if we click on animated charts, we can now go through each individual day of week, which is our grouping field. Let's switch back to the stack charts option. And let's switch out a data field. So let's take out our group by day of week. Let's throw in quarter instead. From the editor here, you can click on this utility menu and you can change the scale to show as shared, shared individual, or individual. Let's switch that to individual. And you'll see that each of these individual tiles will now show an entire chart, whereas shared will share some of the axes information. From the utility menu, we can also change the layout. So we have it set to auto. We can show it 2x3, 3x3, for example. And then we can also show top in. So this is going to limit the number of panels that we are going to show and group the rest as others. So if we only want to show the top 5 panels, then we can show an others group as well. In the formatting options, we can also change the way the pagination works. We can change from detailed to simple, and that's going to show the number of pages as opposed to detailed, which is going to show us the number of tiles available. From the chart options, we can change between a column chart or an area chart here. If I get rid of my grouping column, such as quarter, I can change this chart type to be a line or lollipop chart as well, or I can select a line chart and then style this how I like. For example, I can select spline and give it a short dot. And now we have a completely different looking visual. We can also add an average panel or average data point. So let's change our average type to be panel, data point, or both. Let's choose both. So we now have an overall average panel and we have an average data point. We can also click on this enlarge button to enlarge that specific panel, and we can make it smaller with the same button. Let's change this back to a bar chart. So let's change that to a column chart. And now let's apply some conditional formatting rules. Let's click plus. Let's add a new conditional formatting rule based on my price column. So where it's less than or equal to 250,000, and click save. And now all of our bars are going to show red if they fall within that category. You can add as many conditional formatting rules as you like. And when you're done, you can exit with this yellow icon. From here, you can drill down to a lower level if you have another field in your category as well. So I can drill down from the month to the day level and see the individual tiles. We see that we now have 364 tiles to choose from. You also have the option to fully customize data labels and axes labels. You have the ability to apply word wrap, rotate these labels, or perform other formatting actions. You can also specify the way numbers are formatted. You can change the decimal separator or the thousand separator or many other options as well. These are some of the key features of the xViz Advanced Trellis Small Multiples visual.